Davisson Germer experiment. Davisson Germer experiment establishes wave nature of electrons. As you know, light has dual nature, particle and wave. And later it was thought that all other particles also have wave nature, that is dual nature. And you are familiar with this relation, lambda equals to h by p. So here we have an attempt to establish wave nature of electron, as we know that electrons are particles. Interference and diffraction are wave nature of particles or wave nature of light. So we are using here diffraction to establish wave nature of electrons. Now, electrons, when are accelerated to certain voltage, gain speed, so they will have momentum, and that can be written as under root of 150 by V, where V is accelerating voltage, which we are using here as accelerating voltage. Now, if I put this V as 54 volt, which they have used in this experiment, we will obtain wavelength of electron as 1.67 angstrom. This is using de Broglie wavelength, which you can say is theoretical wavelength. Davisson Germer is an attempt to establish this using experiment. So the electrons which were accelerated at 54 volt are allowed to hit nickel target. These electron beams, after diffraction, we are using term diffraction because we are assuming that electrons at nickel target or this target will undergo diffraction. There is some reasoning behind it, because as you can see, the wavelength which theoretically we have obtained is 1.67 angstrom, which is closer to X-rays. If you remember, it is closer to X-rays, and X-rays do good diffraction with crystals, because the space between atomic layers is of order of few angstroms. So going by the similarity, that like X-rays, electrons should also show diffraction. So we are using diffraction. When the diffracted electron beam was recorded using a movable detector at various angles, they found that at 54 volt when they were accelerated, then at 50 degree angle, the intensity recorded was maximum. So from the experiment, we have two data, 54 volt and 50 degree, which we will use in Bragg's law. This is the famous Bragg's law relation, delta x is equal to 2d sine theta, which in case of constructive interference is equal to n lambda. So for the nickel crystal, when the total angle is 50 degree, the semi angle will be 25 degree, and therefore this angle will be 65 degree, 90 minus 25 degree. So the extra path which electron beam will travel will be d sine theta, and here also you will have d sine theta, just like Bragg's law. So we have here 2d sine theta. The d for nickel crystal is 0.91 angstrom. So substituting that 0.91 angstrom and this 65 degree, sine of 65 degree, it yields 1.65 angstrom. Now this value is closer to 1.67, which shows that value of n will be 1 here, and the slight difference between 1.65 and 1.67 is well within experimental error. So from experiment also we obtain wavelength of 1.65 angstrom, and from theory we obtain a closer value of 1.67 angstrom. That means the theoretical value which we have here is confirmed from the experiment also. And this was a successful experiment of establishing wave nature of electrons. Later, diffraction of hydrogen molecules and helium atoms also established wave nature of particles, and dual nature gained popularity, that all particles show dual nature given by lambda is equal to h by p. Thank you.